In this video, I'm going to show you how to perform a lookup in an Excel pivot table so you can match information from one column to the right data in another column, all while keeping things as dynamic as possible. Imagine you have a worksheet listing different sales regions in one column and the names of their corresponding markets in another. You build a pivot table to summarize your data by region, but you also want the market names to appear in the pivot table, even if they're not originally part of the data you used to create it. I'll walk you through a couple of strategies to handle that, including the use of a standard lookup formula and some simple if statements, so your pivot table looks neat and doesn't get cluttered with errors. By the way, if you'd like to practice along with me, be sure to download the sample Excel file from the link in the description so you can follow each step exactly and see how it works in real time. First, let's look at a scenario where you already have a pivot table that shows each region, and you want to add a new column that displays the market for that region. One approach is to simply create a new column in the same sheet as your pivot table, right next to the pivot's existing columns, and then write a VLOOKUP formula to pull the market name for each region. To do that, click into an empty cell where you want your market name to appear, and start by typing an equals sign. Next, type VLOOKUP in all capital letters, followed by an open parenthesis. Now pick the cell containing the region name in your pivot table and type a comma. Then switch over or highlight the range in your source data where the first column is the region and the second column is the market. Here, it can be helpful to fix your references so they don't move around if you copy the formula down. If you want to lock the columns and rows, just place a dollar sign before the column letter and before the row number for each part of the range. For example, if your source data is in columns A and B from rows 2 through 19, you could lock them so that your formula will always look at that same exact block of cells whenever you drag down. Once you've finished selecting that block of cells, type another comma. After that, specify which column in your range contains the data you want to retrieve. In our example, it's the second column with the market name, so you type the number 2. Then add another comma to indicate whether you want an exact match or an approximate match. Type false if you want an exact match. Close the parenthesis and press enter. If everything is set up correctly, you should see the right market name appear for that region. Now, that works nicely if you have every single region in your pivot table and you want to pull in every corresponding market. But let's say you filter out certain regions or otherwise make changes to which rows appear. You might run into situations where the VLOOKUP formula tries to reference a blank region cell or a grand total row that doesn't really have a region at all. If that happens, you could start seeing error messages. To make your pivot table display more cleanly, you can wrap your VLOOKUP formula in an if statement so that if the region cell is blank, Excel simply returns nothing. For example, you would start by typing an equals sign, then type if in capital letters, followed by an open parenthesis. First, reference the cell with the region and say equals, and then two quote marks with nothing in between to represent blank. Add a comma, and after that comma, type two quote marks again to indicate you want Excel to display nothing in that case. Then add another comma to move on to the what to do if it's not blank portion, which is where you insert the VLOOKUP steps. Once you've closed out the parenthesis for the VLOOKUP, end the if formula with a closing parenthesis and hit enter. That way, whenever the region cell is blank, you'll get a blank result instead of an error. And if you also notice the pivot table's grand total row is causing trouble, you can go further and use a logical OR statement inside that if statement. For instance, you could say, in words, if the region cell is blank or the region cell says grand total, then just show nothing. Otherwise, run the VLOOKUP. That makes your new market column in the pivot table appear more dynamic because it won't clutter the bottom of the table with errors if the grand total row isn't supposed to show a market name. Still, this approach sometimes feels a bit tacked on if your data or pivot table changes often, and having an extra formula column next to the pivot table might not be the cleanest method. Another option is to add the data you need, like the market name, directly into your source data before building or refreshing the pivot table. Imagine you have a main data set somewhere in your workbook where each row has a region but not a market, and you've been wanting that market information in your pivot. You can simply add a new column to that source data titled market. In that new column, you can type an equal sign, then vlookup, open parenthesis, and pick the region cell in that row. Type a comma, highlight your lookup range that contains regions in the first column and markets in the second. Type another comma, type 2, because that's where the market is located, then one more comma, and finally type false for an exact match. Close the parenthesis, press enter, and fill that formula down for every row in your source data. If you want to keep your file from constantly performing these lookups, you can then convert all of those results into static text by copying and pasting values. In newer versions of Excel, you can press Ctrl plus Shift plus V on Windows right after copying to paste values directly. If your Excel version doesn't have that shortcut, you can right-click and choose the option for Paste Values. That way, you won't have a formula recalculating over and over, and your new market column will just be part of the raw data. Once you've added that new column for market, go back to your pivot table, right-click anywhere in it, and hit refresh. If your pivot table is pointed to the same source data that now includes the market column, you'll be able to drag that field right into the pivot table fields list. Put it where you want, maybe in the rows area, right beside the region, and you'll see each region matched up with its correct market, without having to juggle extra formulas outside the pivot. If the pivot's layout shows subtotals in a way you don't like, just head over to the Pivot Table Design tab on the ribbon and choose a layout option that looks more like a simple table. By switching to a tabular layout, for example, each row will appear more clearly, and your new column won't blend in with the subtotals or totals. Whether you decide to write your VLOOKUP formulas in a column next to your pivot table, or you store the VLOOKUP right in your data source, you should now have a couple of ways to make sure the pivot table displays exactly what you need. If you want to avoid dealing with blank cells, total rows, or other potential annoyances, remember you can always wrap your VLOOKUPs in an if statement, and possibly an or statement, to gracefully handle unexpected data. Or if it's feasible, just incorporate that extra data before creating the pivot in the first place. Either way, you'll end up with a cleaner and more flexible report that keeps the people who use your pivot table happy and free of annoying errors. If you found this video helpful, please subscribe for more Excel tutorials. And don't forget to check the link in the description for the sample file you can download. And now YouTube thinks this next video will make you an Excel wizard. Watch it, or stay stuck in spreadsheet limbo forever. No pressure. See you there.